Good morning, students. Welcome to English class 9. Today we start with Unit 3, Drama Old Man River, written by Dorothy Deming. About the author, Dorothy Deming was an American nurse and famous children's writer and was born on June 8, 1893 at New Haven. She completed her BA graduation in Vassar College in New York in 1914. She attended Yale University, graduate of New York City's Presbyterian Hospital School of Nursing in 1920, studied at Henry Street Visiting Nurse Association. She wrote the book of Practical Nurse, and she died in Jan 1972 in Winter Park. Let's get started with the lesson, Old Man River. The main characters are Amy Marshall, who is 17 years old, Betty Marshall, her younger sister, Dyke, Amy's younger brother, Rose Field, Amy Marshall's neighbor, Sarah Field, Rose's sister, Jim Hall, another neighbor, Mr. Peter, member of Red Cross, and Miss Benny Marshall, Red Cross nurse. Let's start the story in brief. Late afternoon in March, in the living room of Annie Marshall's house, Amy is a girl of 17 years old. Betty, her younger sister, Rosefield, her neighbor, are sitting around the table in the living room. Amy and her neighbor, Rose, are knitting. Knitting means the material which they use to make a sweater. Betty is looking pictures in the magazine. Now, Amy's mom is not at home. She took Dyke, her younger brother, with him to the dentist in the town, and she said that on her way back, she would meet Mrs. Brandt for a recipe. Amy's father is in Chicago on a business. Now, Rose says that it gets dark during this rainy days, and she goes near the window to watch the view. She tells it's rain scares, which means there is a heavy rainfall and the backyard is a small lake. Amy puts on the electric light and goes near the window. Amy joins Rose at the window, telling that she was never seen it raining so heavily. And that is the third day of the rain. Betty, the younger sister of Amy, join them at the window, and she says backyard is not a small lake, it is a sea. She also tells that the radio said the river was above flood stage without knowing the meaning. Amy explained that means the water is above the white line at Thompson Bridge. Now all the three girls are near the window. Suddenly, they hear a noise of shambling feet and they all look at the direction of the voice. That is Jim Hall, a 17 years old neighbor. He is fully wet. He enters heavily because he came running all the way from the school. He says that it is a cloud burst and the river is rising and the Burnett Dam is full an hour ago. Now Jim asked Amy about her parents. Amy tells that her mother and Dyke went to dentist and father is in Chicago. Meanwhile, she gets a call from her mother and she informs that she can't get back home from Mrs. Brandt's home because the bridge between their home are underwater. Her mom asks Rose to spend the night there, informing her mother over phone. When Amy says this to Rose, Rose happily dials the mother to inform her mother about her stay in Amy's house, but she is not getting the connection. Jim explained her that it is because the lines are underwater. The girl get ready by taking precautionary measures. Betty gets ready with flashlight, lamps and candles. Rose is getting ready with filling tubs, bowls, pails with fresh water. Amy and Jim were checking on food, blanket, coats and first aid kits. When the water is up around the garage, Amy first thought it is just a pool in the garden. After Jim's explanation, she understood it is a sea. Amy feels scared, but Jim encourages her, reminding her previous experience and the way they came over safely. Jim also feels glad that he served on the Junior Red Cross Emergency Squad during the war. Suddenly, they hear a child's voice and they recognize it is Sarah, who is in the playhouse in a porch. Porch means veranda. Jim goes to rescue Sarah in rain. On his return with Sarah, Jim cautions them that soon the playhouse will be floating in water. He says that he is going to climb on the roof and start waving the flashlight for someone to come and help them. 1 hour later, all the girls are in the living room. Sarah is sleeping. Betty is trying to read in three candle lights. She says that she can't read by this light. They are discussing about their grandmothers and how they would have read in the candle lights. Maybe they would have gone to bed when the night fall. Jim says the girl to go to the attic with enough food and water. But Amy goes to collect her father's book and her mother's jewels. But Jimmy says that they need water and food more than book and jewels. By the time they hear something outside the house, soon they see it is Peter, a member of Red Cross committee, and Miss Marsh, the Red Cross nurse. They had come in a boat. Mr. Peter asked children about their parents. At that time, Sarah falls from the steps and breaks right leg below the knee. Miss Marsh says that they can support with pillows and umbrella and lift her safely into the boat. And she asked them to take her emergency Red Cross hospital. Mr. Peter takes Sarah, Rose and Betty along with them, leaving Jim and Amy behind with an extra lantern and a jar of coffee, and advising them to stay on roof till they send another boat to save them. Amy thanks Mr. Peter, but Mr. Peter asks her to thank the Red Cross for the timely help. At last, all were safe and rescued with the help of Red Cross committee. So, dear children, I hope you all understood the play. Soon we meet in our next session with more interesting topic. Till that, stay home, stay safe. Thank you, children.